Hi everyone, this is Marika Lamro, and this video is going to explain how to interpret whether there's an interaction when you are looking at a graph. So the first thing I'm going to do is show this video. It's one of the longer videos that I'll show, but I think it is totally worth it because this guy is hilarious and inspirational, and the rest of this video for my explanation isn't that long. So, here we go.
Hi, I'm Zach Anner, and welcome to Workout Wednesdays, the workout show where I teach you how to have a great body like mine. This week, we're going to be doing pull-ups, and I know a lot of you are at home thinking, I can't do pull-ups. My body sucks. I suck. My body's the shape of an orange. Well, guess what? I think you just need a little pick-me-up. So for every pull-up I do, I'm going to be saying something great about you, because you're great and you don't even know it yet. Here's what you need. 1, workout shirt. 2, workout shorts. 3, workout socks. 4, hands. 5, a great attitude. Let's do this.
The first thing you gotta do is raise your wheelchair up. If you don't have a wheelchair, stand.
This is what it means to be hardcore.
All right, we're ready to be badass. Who's feeling like a workout? Me? You're great. You've got a fantastic attitude. You light up a room.
Oh, I can't sit down when I'm doing them. Hold on. I'll back up just a little bit more so I'm having to stand.
I don't want to cheat you out of my workout, guys.
Those are too easy. Got a seatbelt up my ass.
Here we go, now it's a workout. You're fantastic! That's a great haircut on you! Oh my goodness, this is harder than it looks, but you're still incredible! Keep it up!
Hold on, we'll do more. How many was that?
Let's try these. See if they're easier. Oh, nope!
We're gonna do more. Just a second.
Let's do this again, huh? You make the best guacamole, Janine! I never knew you had such a talent for music! I know I'll be the only one to tell you this, but you have a magnificent ass!
How many do we do total? Like 6?
I think maybe like 10.
Oh. Well, 10's nice. We could do 15. If 10 was that easy.
Well, you're almost on your way to an awesome body like mine.
One more?
Yeah, one more.
Right now, or are you going to take a break?
Oh, we'll just take a little break. Alright, we've taken a little break to recharge our awesome, and now we're ready to go again.
You've got a beautiful smile! I love the way you go to the zoo! You can do anything you set your mind to, except for time travel, because that's impossible due to the laws of physics! Oh!
So, that's the first Workout Wednesday. You're well on your way to being great like me. Hope this brightened your day a little bit. Remember to subscribe for other things as cool as this. Subscribe. All right. Okay. I'm good. I'm just going to rest in the doorway.
So, I was laughing so hard after I watched that video that I had tears in my eyes. So, I hope that you are in a fantastic mood as well, and you are ready to start learning how to interpret interactions from graphs. So this is the sample problem that we're going to use. So what we're going to be doing is saying that this cookbook company wants to know if the food type, whether something is gourmet or not gourmet, and the region, if it's American or French, influence cookbook sales. So we have two independent variables, food type and region, and our dependent variable is sales. If you've already watched the other video on interactions, this will be familiar to you. An interaction is essentially testing whether the effect of one independent variable depends on the level of another independent variable. And there's really not a straightforward way to explain what an interaction is, because the point of an interaction is to kind of say it's complicated. To understand what's going on in the study, you need to know about a bunch of the different independent variables. So do you need to know about more than one independent variable to accurately understand what happened in the study? Another way of thinking about it is to say, is there a special combination of independent variables that creates a unique effect? So for our sample problem, what we'll be looking for is, does the food type's effect on cookbook sales depend on the food's region? Okay, how do you know if there's an interaction? Well, first, you can assume that all differences are significant unless you're actually looking in an article, but if you're doing a homework or on a quiz or an exam, you can assume that any differences in a graph are significant. And it's really easy to determine whether or not there's an interaction. You just need to look and see if the lines are parallel. And if they are parallel, then there's no interaction. And if they are not parallel, then there is an interaction. So let's see some examples. So here's example one. You can see that the American, the line for the American is drawn in gray with the little circles, and the line for French cookbooks is drawn in black in a dashed line with a little square. And so what we need to do is say, are the lines parallel? Well, the lines are not parallel, so that means there is an interaction. And now we need to interpret it. So essentially what you're doing when you're interpreting it is you're kind of explaining what the picture looks like in the graph. So this is what I say when I'm explaining what the picture looks like, and I'll give you a chance to read it before I talk. So if you look at the picture, you can see that in my interpretation, I'm basically explaining what's going on. So the first thing I say is that people buy equal numbers of American and French gourmet cookbooks. So the first thing I'm doing is explaining that in the upper left-hand corner, that those two data points are at the same point. And then I also say that they buy equal numbers of American, gourmet, and not gourmet cookbooks. So I'm saying for the American line that line is flat. So people are buying the same amount of cookbooks, whether they're gourmet or not gourmet for Americans. And then the last thing I say is, but they do not buy as many French not gourmet cookbooks. So now I'm explaining that bottom right hand point, saying, hey, that point is different from all the other ones. It's lower. There are a number of different ways that you can describe what's going on in a graph, and on a test, you don't need to, there's not one way that you would describe it, and that's the only right way. As long as you get across what the graph looks like, then you are explaining what the interaction is. So let's look at another example. So we need to say whether or not the lines are parallel. They are parallel, and if the lines are parallel, that means there's no interaction. So this is an example of a graph that's showing no significant interaction. Here's our next example. We need to decide whether the lines are parallel, and of course, they are not parallel, and now we'll interpret that interaction. So here's my interpretation, and I'll give you a chance to read it. And when you're ready to move on, then unpause the video and I'll talk about it. Okay, so this is, I'm describing this interaction by first explaining the top of the graph and saying, well, the gourmet French and the not gourmet, American cookbooks are selling the most. And then I explain the bottom of the graph and saying that they're not buying as many American gourmet and French not gourmet cookbooks. Again, there's a lot of different ways that you could explain what's going on in this graph. This is just the way that I did it. Here's a fourth example. So we need to answer the question of whether the lines are parallel. They are parallel, which means there's no interaction. And here's the last example. Are the lines parallel? No, they are not. There is indeed an interaction, and here's how I interpret it. So we have people, or I'm sorry, when I am explaining this graph, I'm starting in the upper right-hand corner, and I'm explaining that the American and the French not gourmet are the highest points. And then I'm just going through and sort of explaining what comes next. So then the next data point is the American gourmet, and the lowest data point is the French gourmet. As always, there's a number of different ways that you could have explained this. This is just one of them. And that's it. We're done learning how to interpret interactions. It's really straightforward. You just look to see whether or not the lines are parallel. If they are parallel, then it means there's no interaction. If they are not parallel, it means there is an interaction. And then you just sort of, in words, describe the way the graph looks like. As always, if this was not enough for you, then I strongly encourage you to take advantage of any or all of these resources to help you feel more comfortable with this content.